An exciting and daring new space age is coming. This is an incredibly exciting time to be in the space industry. Globally, we're seeing tremendous growth across commercial space. You're seeing incredible amounts of ground stations. You're seeing incredible numbers of new startup companies. The cloud provides many distinct advantages for space applications. It provides space customers secure, flexible, scalable, and cost-efficient solutions to support their missions. And it can help us move really fast, delivers insights from data within moments of capture. AWS is helping lower the barriers to entry that organizations in the space industry once faced. Space isn't just for wealthy nations or large aerospace corporations anymore. We're seeing organizations of all sizes being able to play a part because AWS gives them the infrastructure, the speed, and the security they need to be successful. What we're learning is as we start working more effectively in space, we're improving how we actually live and work here on Earth as well. Our satellite customers and partners are using cloud tools like SageMaker, artificial intelligence, and machine learning to analyze huge amounts of data quickly and deliver results to decision makers. For example, Exi, a startup based in Australia, is actually using AWS to capture both sensor data in space as well as sensor data on the ground, and then fuse it together, and it uses AWS machine learning algorithms to help detect wildfires quickly. They're actually processing more than 2.5 million images a day on AWS to identify the outbreak of a fire within 3 minutes so that they can detect that fire and then alert and notify first responders and help save lives. Gatehouse Maritime is also using AWS to provide critical data analytics about ship monitoring to the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Agency in order to assist their efforts to protect endangered whales near the coast of California. They can actually use that data to look at where ships are, where they're going, and then compare that with other information to help protect the whales. Satellite View is monitoring the energy and the greenhouse gas emissions of man-made structures around the globe. They use that data to address climate change. And then cloud technology is helping them process huge volumes of infrared imagery and videos from its infrared satellites in near real time. So next, let me give you a ground station case study where we can actually show from talking with one of our great customers, Satellogic, how we can actually create a searchable Earth on the cloud. We're seeing a dramatic increase in the amount of data being brought down from space every day. AWS provides the tools and the infrastructure necessary to help turn this growing stream of space data into actionable insights or knowledge. One way AWS is doing this is with the AWS Ground Station service. Ground Station is a fully managed service that lets customers control their satellite communications, their downlinks, their uplinks and commanding, and process that satellite data that they downlink, and then scale their operations to match their operations tempo, and they only pay for the time that they use. Because of AWS Ground Station, space companies are able to operate around the globe and only pay for what they use. A great example of this is Satellogic, who's doing it to great success. Satellogic is actually using space data to address climate change and energy resource management. By combining their advanced Earth imaging technology with the cloud, their decision makers and customers have access to a continually refreshed source of global, high-quality data. Satellogic actually tells us that they're collecting as much as 50 gigabytes of data per day in each of their 17 satellites in their satellite constellation. They plan to use AWS as they expand their constellation to more than 300 satellites by 2025. Satellogic can acquire the computer power it needs to process and store that 1.5 terabytes of data every day that the 300 satellites will collect by just clicking a couple of buttons on their AWS console to change how much data they need to process. And so next, let's talk about another one of our great customers who's revolutionizing the launch industry. We're talking about Astra. Astra is actually using the cloud to revolutionize their launch industry. I'm excited about Korea's NURI rocket program. Their recent rocket launch and its success in putting satellites into orbit is a significant achievement, and it clearly demonstrates Korea's ambitions in space. Congratulations. I'd like to use a use case about the launch company that AWS is working with in this case, Astra, who's also using the cloud to accelerate their mission of offering frequent, low-cost launch services for small satellites. The AWS Cloud is revolutionizing the industry's approach to aerospace processes like design, engineering, and modeling and simulation. Traditionally, these design processes take considerable money and time. Shifting these tasks to the cloud has the potential to save aerospace manufacturers significant time and cost. Astra delivered its first commercial payload into Earth orbit in 2021, a big achievement, making it the fastest company in history to reach the milestone, just 5 years after it was founded in 2016, in fact. So how did they do it? Astra was built in the cloud. In fact, they say that being a cloud-first company is in their DNA. Everything at Astra, from designing a part, to sourcing materials, to testing and integration and flying their rockets, and then even to financial management and looking at financial information, is done on the cloud. Astra's rockets are born digital. Astra uses the AWS Cloud to design and build their rockets and get data insights more quickly. It allows them to iterate, innovate, and automate fast, and that gives them an advantage in the competitive launch industry. The beginning of the rocket building journey is creating their digital designs and models. They go through rigorous simulations and tests. They're doing all sorts of finite element models, all the different aspects of engineering that goes into building a rocket. And then that allows Astra to evolve their rockets much faster on the cloud than if they moved straight to the hardware environment. So Astra can also run thousands and thousands of these runs, simulations, and experiments to get their design exactly right before they start bending metal, as we say, or building the rocket. This type of digital engineering, powered by the AWS Cloud, could also accelerate Korea's ICT and Science Ministry's efforts to develop high-performance liquid fuel engines by next year. Next, let's talk about how we're going to be processing data at the edge. We want to process that data at the edge so that we can demonstrate to our customers and to the world that you can use cloud at the ultimate edge, out in space. I'm going to end with a recent example of how AWS is paving the way for future space missions. Axiom and AWS worked together to successfully integrate and operate an AWS snow cone with an SSD in it on the International Space Station as part of the AX-1 mission in April. This demonstration marks the first time that AWS has remotely operated a general-purpose edge processing and storage device on the ISS. For this demonstration, one of our engineers, Daryl Shook, and our Snow Family team had to provide a solution that would allow high-resolution photos to be used as an example of large data sets. Each one of these photos was over 20 megabytes in size. We communicated remotely with the snow cone device and used it to perform edge processing on the ISS. This is important because AWS is committed to continuing to remove barriers that the space industry has traditionally faced, such as the latency that's involved in processing space data and sending it back to the Earth. In the long term, our vision is that future human spaceflight missions, and including future space stations like the Axiom station, will incorporate advanced cloud-based technology. This demonstration that we did is going to allow our teams to begin assessing how to improve the availability of cloud processing capability to support future on-orbit research and crew needs.